One common stereotype is that older people are lonely, they're all alone, and they don't have contact with others. This is Australian Bureau of Statistics data, and it's similar to other Western developed countries, and it shows that over 90% of people over 65 have regular contact with family and friends. Older people are definitely connected. Only 1% of respondents said that they had no recent contact. If you are lonely and isolated, that does put you at greater increased risk for physical health and mental health issues, but most older people are connected. In the modern era, the incidence of grandparents assuming informal or formal responsibility for raising grandchildren is rising globally. This is an interesting shift in the structure of families that will continue to be more common for some years to come. Whether in the developed or the developing world, grandparents who assume full-time care of grandchildren face many financial and health challenges, given the demands of such care. In addition, they may experience social isolation from peers or the loss of friends, children, or partners who do not support them in their responsibilities. Stereotypes in our culture often depict older people as non-sexual humans. Either they don't need it, or if they have sexual desire, that is somehow unacceptable. This is ageism. Research has demonstrated the value of intimacy for older persons. The positive effect of having a partner in later life on one's health and emotional well-being has been demonstrated across countries. While longer-term partnerships are more frequently studied, recently the development of new romantic relationships in later life has been the subject of research. For example, older adults develop new relationships seeking companionship and sexual activity, but may be less interested in progressing to cohabitation or marriage than younger cohorts. Maintaining independence, economic factors, the influence of family and friends, and healthcare concerns are some of the factors that shape romantic relationships in later life. This has led to the phenomenon of living apart together, or LAT, LAT, a type of relationship choice also more popular with older rather than younger adults. Nevertheless, both qualitative and quantitative research with older adults emphasizes their continued interest in engaging with romantic partners who share interests and values. Finally, older adults with adequate social relationships are 50% more likely to survive than those with insufficient social support, an effect comparable to quitting smoking, and of greater benefit than avoiding obesity and lack of exercise.